J.M. Barrie's Peter Pan. The red-skinned Princess Tiger Lily did not forget that Peter Pan had saved her life, and every night she and her braves kept watch over the underground home. Peter and the Lost Boys had been expecting a skirmish for a long time. It finally came, on an evening when Wendy had told her favorite story. It was all about Wendy, John, and Michael leaving the Neverland and flying back home. Their mother, she said, had always left the nursery window open in the hope that they would return. It was Peter's least favorite story, and when it was finished, he groaned.
Wendy, you are wrong about mothers, he said. Long ago, I thought, like you, that my mother would always keep the window open for me. So I stayed away for moons and moons and then flew back. But the window was barred, for mother had forgotten all about me, and there was another little boy sleeping in my bed.
John and Michael were scared.
Wendy, let us go home, they cried together.
At once, replied Wendy firmly. Peter, please arrange it.
If you wish,
he said coolly. He did not want Wendy to leave, but he would not show it. So he went off to ask the Redskins to guide her through the wood. When he returned, the Lost Boys were crowding round Wendy, pleading with her not to go.
No, please don't, Wendy, you can't leave us. No!
It would be worse than before you came, they cried.
Dear ones, she said, if you come with me, I feel almost sure I can get my mother and father to adopt you. At once, all the boys jumped with joy.
All, that is, except Peter Pan. He told Wendy that he would not be going, for he could do very well without a mother. He would not even show her the way back home. Instead, he would send Tinkerbell to guide her across the sea. Peter skipped up and down the room, playing gaily on his pipes. Now then, he cried, no fuss, no blubbering. Goodbye, Wendy. And he held out his hand, cheerily. Wendy had to take his hand, as it seemed that he did not want a kiss. Then Peter called on Tinkerbell to lead the way, and the little fairy darted up the nearest tree. But no one followed, for suddenly they heard shrieks and the clash of steel. The pirates had appeared out of the shadows of the night and taken the Redskins completely by surprise. A tremendous battle followed, and only Tiger Lily and a few trusted braves managed to escape with their lives. But the Lost Boys did not know this. When the sounds of battle had died away, they asked who had won. And the pirates, standing by the hollow trees, heard Peter's answer.
If the Redskins have won, they will beat the Tom Tom. It is always their sign of victory.
Hook smiled grimly and signaled to Smee to beat the Tom Tom. After two beats, they heard Peter cry,
an Indian victory!
Hooray!
The children answered with a cheer and almost immediately repeated their goodbyes to Peter.
The pirates smirked at each other and rubbed their hands.
Quickly, Hook ordered one man to stand beside each hollow tree and the others to arrange themselves in a line. When the first boy emerged from his tree, he found himself in the arms of the pirate Checo, who flung him to Smee, who flung him to Starkey, and so on, until he fell at the feet of Captain Hook. All the boys were plucked from their trees in this ruthless way, and several of them were in the air at one time. Wendy was treated differently. Hook raised his hat to her and escorted her to the spot where the others were being doubled up and tied with their knees close to their ears. Only slightly could not be tied up in this way, for every time they tried to pack him tight in one part, he bulged out in another. It did not take Hook long to realize what this meant. Slightly, who could not stop drinking water in hot weather, had swollen up. Then, instead of reducing himself to fit his tree, he had whittled his tree to make it fit him. Any average-sized man could now get down and up
Slightly's tree. Hook ordered his men to fling the children into Wendy's little house, and the four stoutest men to raise it on their shoulders and carry it to the ship.
Yo-ho, yo-ho!
Singing their hateful song, the pirates set off through the wood. As soon as he was alone, Hook tiptoed to Slightly's tree and listened for any sound from below. All was as silent as above, so he climbed into the hollow trunk and let himself go into the unknown. He had feared that Peter would be waiting for him, dagger in hand. But when he reached the bottom, he saw, over the top of Slightly's door, that Peter was fast asleep. Hook reached down for the catch of the door and found, to his fury, that it was beyond his reach. He rattled the door and flung himself against it. Then he noticed something standing on a ledge within easy reach. It was a cup of medicine that Wendy had left for Peter. She was always chiding him to take it. Hook knew that Peter was in his power. Shaking with joy, he took a small bottle of yellow liquid poison from his pocket and poured 5 drops into Peter's cup. Then, after one long, gloating look, he wormed his way up the tree and sped into the wood. Peter slept on. He slept until he was woken by an excited Tinkerbell.
Oh, you could never guess,
she cried. And then she told Peter about the capture of Wendy and the boys and how they had been taken to the pirate ship.
I'll rescue Wendy,
cried Peter, leaping for his dagger. As he leapt, he thought of something he could do to please her. He picked up his cup to take his medicine.
No!
Shrieked Tinkerbell.
It's poisoned! I heard Hook muttering about it as he went through the wood.
Don't be silly, said Peter. How could Hook have got down here? And he raised the cup to drink. There was no time for words. With one of her lightning movements, Tink got between his lips and the medicine and drank every drop. In a moment, she was reeling in the air.
It was poisoned,
she said softly.
And now I am going to die.
Then she tottered to her tiny bed and lay down. Peter knelt beside her, and as her light grew fainter, tears ran down his face.
I could get well again,
she whispered.
If I knew that children believed in fairies.
Peter flung out his arms to all the children who might be dreaming of the Neverland.
If you believe, he cried, clap your hands. Don't let Tink die.
All over the world, children clapped, and as they clapped, Tink's light grew stronger, and she popped out of her bed and flashed through the room, merrier than ever.
And now, to rescue Wendy, cried Peter. This time, it's Hook or me.